Hey, this is Tim, and I'm here to show you BPOS point of sale for retail stores. This screen right here is the login screen, where you log into the point of sale and the login decides your permissions. So you can log in using a number. I could use an employee card and swipe into the system. I have an option for a fingerprint that you could use. You could press your finger on the system to get in. And in this case, I'm demonstrating a wristband. So I have a wristband. I just touch my wrist to the system and it logs me in. So this screen right here is obviously made to be touchscreen friendly. You can use the touchscreen to ring up items. The touchscreen can be handy to ring up items that don't have barcodes. Maybe you have services. There might be products that are just so small that you can't put a barcode on them, like mints on your counter. And sometimes the touchscreen can just be handy to look up items. And I can press a button and search for products in the science category or any other category that I wanted to. I could even have buttons that I press one button and it rings up the product. I might also be able to scan barcodes, and I can scan barcodes as many as we want to. I scan a couple products here. Now, I have a total here of $15.30. Now, of course, I can press the cash button and type in any amount, but I do have fast tender keys down here, which would allow me to hit a $20 bill. If I press a $20 bill, the receipt printer prints and the cash drawer opens. That's so easy you can teach a monkey to do it in 10 minutes. Now, there are a couple other ways to do transactions. You might run into situations where you want to look and see if you have product on hand. And I can actually look, and on the screen, I can display the quantity on hand. So I know that I have 7 packages of gummy words on the shelf and 5 packages of retail gummy bears. All of my candy tools are out of stock, and every other thing on the screen has so many that the system doesn't need to demonstrate it because over 100, there's no quantity displayed. Now, sometimes you'll have a situation where the barcode on the product is obscured. Maybe the barcode got ripped off, maybe something made a mark on it and the system can't read the barcode, or for any other reason, the system just isn't reading the barcode, I could actually type in a part of the barcode number. So I could go in here and press product scan and type in here, I can see 6827, and it brings up every product in the system that has 6827 anywhere in the barcode. Now I can see that bottled water is the product that I'm ringing up, so it automatically rang it up. Now I could also search for the product. So I could type in, for instance, gummy bears. So I'll just type in gummy. And everything that has gummy anywhere in the name will come right to the top. So I'll pick a product. And when that product comes up, you can see I've got a picture on it, I've got more information. Depending on my permissions, I might be able to see more on this product. And depending on my permissions and our operations, I might be able to see the inventory levels on this product at all stores in our enterprise. In this case, in this database, I have 13 stores and I can check the inventory at all 13 stores. So let's pretend that somebody comes into your store, they come to the counter, they ring up 10 items, and then when they're all ready to pay, they realize that they forgot their wallet in their car. You may have a line of other customers waiting to check out, and you don't want to make those other customers wait, and neither do you want to delete that entire transaction and start over again when that customer comes back from their car. So I'll ring up a couple items on the transaction. I'm just putting some items on here quickly, and I can put that transaction on hold. Now I can ring up all the other customers who are coming into the store and take payments on them. And when that customer comes back in with their wallet to take a payment, I can retrieve the transaction and continue where I left off with payment. Now, many businesses want to have customer loyalty for their system. Now, you could bring up your customer loyalty accounts by searching for their name, searching for their phone number. We could issue a card for them. If they took their card and used their favorite app on their phone to store the card, you could scan the card through their phone app. There's many different ways to look up a customer. In this case, I have a card and I will swipe the card to pull up somebody's customer loyalty account. Now, I've pulled up their account And you can see in the upper left-hand corner, I have the ability to capture a picture on the person. I have their points balance. I have a prepaid account balance. We could actually do wholesale accounts and keep customer statements if you wanted to do those kind of things. And there are multiple ways that we can do customer loyalty. What you see in the marketplace for customer loyalty are things like, if you spend $100, you'll get a certain number of points that you can redeem for store credit. You might spend $100 and get a free widget. There are other methodologies that you can use for customer loyalty, and BPOS can do almost all of them. What BPOS adds on top of that customer loyalty is tiered loyalty and marketing. So tiered loyalty is, I could have a bronze and silver and gold, platinum, titanium, however many different levels you want. And at each level, the rewards could change. So I could then say, if you spent $100 with us, we'll give you $5 in store credit if you're an entry-level loyalty member. But once you've spent $1,000 with us, if you spend $100, we'll give you $7 in credit. And once you've spent $5,000 with us, once you spend $100, we'll give you $10 in credit. So, and we could do this on each of the different kinds of systems. That would be possible. Now, we can also do things like your grocery store, which is you get discounts based on your loyalty level. So when you become a gold member, then automatically certain items are discounted for you, or certain promotions only apply to you. So we have a buy one, get one free option that's available for the month of August. And that buy one, get one free option is only available for gold members. So we'll do a couple of these options just so we can see. So I've pulled up this person and their loyalty account. And when I ring up items, you'll see automatically that their discount applies immediately. So they have a discount that's already applying. And in this particular case, this person has earned a reward on coffee. So when I ring up a coffee for this person, it says they have a voucher. And in this case, they have multiple vouchers because this is a very loyal customer. They have lots of vouchers available because they've been accruing coffees for a while. So I can see that I have a bunch of vouchers, and I'm going to redeem a voucher, and that voucher will automatically apply, and they now got a free coffee. Now their other items are not free. They're still just discounted. Okay. Now that voucher has been pulled out of the system. It will no longer work. They've redeemed their reward, and the reward's no longer active, and the customer got the free coffee they expected. So that's BPOS point of sale for retail stores. If you have one store or many stores, BPOS has the tools that can help your business succeed. Of course, in this demonstration, we cannot show every possible feature. So if there's some feature that you haven't seen, or if you'd like a demonstration or a proposal, call us today and we'll be happy to show you BPOS.